Hello, I'm Geoff Kersey, and I was out and about recently looking for some subjects for paintings, and I came across this old ruined mill, which I thought was perfect. This is really just the shell of a building with nature gradually taking over. So while I was there, I took some photographs and did a quick pencil sketch. I particularly want to explore the variety of colours in the stonework and the textures, so I've chosen a particularly rough piece of 300-pound paper onto which I've drawn the subject and applied some masking fluid. So first of all, I'm going to mix some colours with this large number 16 brush to represent the sky and a suggestion of distant trees in the background. I'm starting with a wash of ultramarine blue. Nothing too strong, a fairly thin wash at first. I'm going to add to that a little touch of rose madder. Another thin wash, this time of cerulean blue. And then with a number 10 brush, I'm going to take some more ultramarine and rose madder and add a little bit of burnt sienna to it to make a sort of soft grey, a mixture of raw sienna and burnt sienna for a touch of warmth. And I've got to have all these ready because I'm painting them onto the wet background. And finally, I want a dark green, and I'm going to take aureoline, ultramarine blue, and a little touch of burnt sienna. So now I'm going to take a 1-inch flat brush, plenty of clean water on it, and wet the background area. The idea of putting the masking fluid on the outline of the building is so that I can paint this quite freely without losing the shape of the walls, the chimney and the roof. Get it nice and wet. And then with the number 16 brush again. And the ultramarine blue with a touch of rose madder. I drop a bit of colour into the very top of the sky. And then straight away I'm introducing the cerulean blue, which is cooler, it's a cooler blue. And I'm bringing that lower down. If the sky gets a bit cooler in colour towards the horizon, it does help with that feeling of aerial perspective. A bit more darker blue at the top right-hand corner and the top left. Now I need to leave that to dry for a minute or so that I can put the next colour in just before it's fully dry. Now, just as the shine started to go off the paper, I think this is the right time to start adding a bit of background colour. So with a number 10 brush and the mixture of ultramarine, rose madder and burnt sienna, I'm just going to start by dropping a bit of colour in behind the building. The main reason for this colour is to give me a bit of contrast to the light I will have on the walls later on. Working rapidly before the paint dries, I've got the raw sienna and burnt sienna. I'm dropping a bit of that in as well. So that the nearer we get to the stonework, the more intense the colour is. I think we'll have a bit more of that one. Raw sienna. Maybe this time a touch more burnt sienna to make it slightly more orange. And then I'm going to introduce just a few touches of the dark green. This is the mixture of aureoline, ultramarine and burnt sienna. Again, darkening the colour nearest to the mill and nearest to the ground. Okay, so that needs to dry before I can go on to the next stage. And I'm now going to get the number 6 brush, make sure it's clean, and I'm going to pick up a little bit more of that ultramarine with a touch of rose madder and start to put a bit of colour into these old windows and doorways where you glimpse the background through them. Bit of cerulean blue now. Touch into that one as well. And then following the same procedure as for the background, some raw sienna and burnt sienna. Letting these colours mix and merge on the paper. Don't have to be too neat and tidy because it's not nice, neat, modern stonework. And then some of that dark that's lower down in the background just glimpsed through these gaps. And a touch of the raw sienna and burnt sienna in there as well. We'll let that dry.